Hi, this is Amanda from the Hong Kong Maemo Moblin MeeGo user group. Today I would like to show you how we can share our Nokia N900 Internet Connection with other mobile devices, a technique usually known as tethering. There are three ways of tethering, each has its pros and cons, and I will go through all of them in this video. The first way to do tethering is to make use of a micro USB cable. As you can see, I've got a very short micro USB cable with me, with one end connecting to the Nokia and another end connecting to my Asus EPC. You'll be asked for connection mode once you have connected the cable to the both ends. Select PC Suite mode. At the netbook side, you will have to download and install the Nokia PC Suite software first. This piece of software is available for download at the Nokia.com website. Launch the PC Suite software by double-clicking its icon in the system tray. Then click the Connect to Internet icon in the PC Suite. Then, a new window pops up telling you that the connection will be established within 10 seconds using the Nokia N900 USB modem. The connection is now established. So let's try to play some YouTube clips. USB tethering is straightforward enough, but we don't always have a micro USB cable around us. We can do tethering using Bluetooth connection instead. First, you need to install a piece of software called Bluetooth Startup Networking in the N900. This software is available for download in the extras repository of the application manager. After you have installed this software, turn on the Bluetooth feature in both devices, and then launch the PC Suite software at the netbook side. Connect to the N900 using Bluetooth. You may be asked to enter the given pairing code to your N900 when you are pairing for the first time. Once your N900 is connected to the netbook using Bluetooth, you can then connect your netbook to the internet using the same Connect to Internet icon as described previously.
Let me show you something in the N900 that I'm especially proud of. I'm talking about the mighty Maemo browser that brings the full internet into your pocket.
If you own a previous generation of Nokia internet tablet like this N810 that I'm now holding, you may also set up Bluetooth connection so that you can access internet anywhere through the N900. In the connection wizard, key in a name for the connection, select packet data, and specify your service provider's access point name and use *99# as dial-up number. Then you should be able to connect to the internet using the connection name you specified. For both the USB and Bluetooth tethering techniques, only one device can be connected to the N900 for internet sharing. We can, however, purchase a piece of software called Joyco Sport, which makes your N900 become a 3G router, providing a Wi-Fi hotspot for multiple devices. This software is available for download at joycoolshop.com for the price of 15 euros. They now offer it for 7 euros for the first 1,000 customers. So if you're interested in this, you better check this out in their website. Once installed, you can set up various Wi-Fi related settings as if you were setting up a router. You can set up DHCP settings, SSID, Wi-Fi channel, encryption level and password, and also the WAN access point allowable for sharing. Click the Share Internet icon to start sharing. So let me connect my N810 using the Joyco Sport hotspot. And let me connect my EPC using the Joyco Sport connection too. As you can see, I'm playing YouTube videos on both devices and both of them are playing nicely. You can refer to the speed meter for the download and upload speed. And you can also get a list of devices that are currently connected to your N900. This video demonstrates the three possible ways of internet connection sharing using your N900. They are not comparable to dedicated devices such as the MeeGo in terms of performance and stability. All these techniques drain out your N900 battery very quickly, so bear in mind that they are for ad hoc usages only.